Now, what is an ether? As I already told you that when we replace one of the hydrogen atom with an alkoxy or an alkoxy group, we get the ether. What is the alkoxy group? As you already know, OR, and this is the O with an aromatic ring. Right. So, we classify ether actually into a symmetrical ether and an unsymmetrical ether, or we can say a simple ether and a complex ether. Right. So, what is actually a symmetrical ether? Symmetrical ether is that in which the two groups present on the either side of functional group, as we know that we have this ROR, right. So, in which these R are similar to each other, as you can see, this is methyl, this is methyl. So, it belongs to a category of the symmetrical ether. And likewise, you can see that it is an aryl group, this is an aryl group, again an R and R are same. So, it belongs to a category of symmetrical ether. So, that means when the R and R, that whether it is an alkyl groups, whether they are two aryl groups, when they are similar to each other, they belong to a symmetrical ether category. And when they are dissimilar, as you can see that in this case, it is CH3 and in this case, it is C2H5. So, that means this is methyl and this is ethyl. So, we can say these R are actually different. So, I have just put one as R, other as R dash. So, when they are different from each other, we say that they fall in the category of unsymmetrical ether. Likewise, you can see that this is an alkyl group and this is an aryl group, like this. So, that means again the different groups, so that means it belongs to a category of unsymmetrical ether. So, this is how you need to classify ether into a symmetrical and an unsymmetrical type.